Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. This is my fourth video in the video lecture series of Internet of Things. In this video, I'll be discussing about statistics of IoT. So after watching this video, you'll get to know like what are the future scopes of IoT and how growth of IoT is happening in this current world. So let us start this session with first agenda, in which I'll be going to explain you current and future statistics of IoT. So to understand current and future statistics of IoT, I'll explain you one graph. By that graph, you'll get to know like how exactly IoT growth is happening with respect to years. So let me show you that graph step by step. So here on horizontal axis, I'll explain you years, and on vertical axis, I'll show you number of IoT devices, and those devices will be there in terms of billions. So what I'll do is I'll explain you number of IoT devices with respect to world's population. So if you talk about 2021, then in 2021, there were around 11.3 number of IoT devices with respect to world's population of 7.9 billion. So you can say almost per single human being, aggregated number of IoT devices were around 1.3. If you talk about 2022, then IoT devices have increased to 13.1 billion, whereas world's population have reached to 8.0 billion. It is expected that in 2023, number of IoT devices that will be reaching up to 15.1 billion, whereas world's population will be reaching to 8.03 billion. So with respect to world's population, if you observe IoT devices growth, then that is quite faster, right? If you talk about 2024, then it is expected that number of devices will be reaching to 17.1 billion in future at the end of 2024. Whereas world's population will be reaching up to 8.1 billion. So you can say more than two devices will be there per single human being as per this ratio. Right. In 2025, IoT devices that is expected to be around 19.1 billion. Whereas world's population that will be reaching up to 8.2 billion. In 2030, if you talk about number of IoT devices, then that will be reaching up to 29.4 billion. Whereas world's population that is expected around 8.5 billion. So at the end of 2030, you can say per single human being, there will be more than three IoT devices. So based on this statistics, there are a few basic conclusions that you can easily understand. See, number of IoT devices are increasing in this planet. And based on that, IoT applications are also increasing, right? And here, projection of number of devices per single human being that is also increasing with respect to time, right? So here one thing that you can say easily, see here, change is the only permanent thing which is there in this world. So world is changing very fast, that you can say. And here automation on internet, that is also growing very fast. And that technology is Internet of Things. Now, I'm going to explain you a few very interesting facts regarding Internet of Things. Now, I'm going to explain you some interesting facts regarding IoT in with respect to 2020. So, in 2020, there were around 5.4 billion number of IoT devices from consumer segment. And if you want to know who is the leader, then China was the leader, where there were around 3.17 billion IoT devices connected from China. So China was the leader among all the countries. Here, one interesting fact that you should know. See, in a single second, around 127 number of new IoT devices are connected on web, means on the internet, right? Here, you should know one thing. See, 50% of those IoT devices, or you can say IoT platforms, focused on industrial and manufacturing industries. So in industrial and manufacturing industry also, almost 50% IoT devices that is getting added, that you can see. And see, 13.6 zettabyte amount of data was generated by IoT devices in 2019 alone. So humongous data that is getting generated by IoT devices, as IoT devices are connected on the internet. So you can understand one thing clearly. See, IoT growth is very vast nowadays, and in future even you will be observing that will be going to increase only. It is not like it is getting saturated over here, right? That is how these interesting facts may trigger you to work out with IoT. Let us move on to next interesting segment of this video. Now, I'll explain you how top IoT categories are there based on 2020 market share. So, in 2020, how market share was there with different IoT categories, that I'll explain you by one pie chart. So, in pie chart, you can observe here, I have bisected top IoT categories in terms of area. So, I'll explain you that with respect to percentage here. So, if you talk about smallest category, then that was having percentage share of 7.4% that belongs to other connectivity, where it has a share of wired and wireless connection. So, in a structure of IoT also, I have explained there is a need of connectivity. And along with connectivity, I have explained you gateway as well. So, there were varieties of protocols. For short distance, we have varieties of protocols like ZigBee, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, NFC, right? For a range of around 5 km, we have a protocols based on cellular technology where we have 2G, 3G, 5G, right? And for hundreds of kilometers also, there were some protocols. So, here that is been provided with respect to connectivity protocols that is having share of around 7.4%. Secondly, we have share of application software where it is having sharing of 11.7%. It is there to deliver value and enhance the user experience. So, using application software, we are delivering value and enhance user experience so that many people can use IoT services, right? Now, as if you talk about third category, so that is having share of 14.2% that belongs to IT and installation services. It is used to provide IT solutions for various IT industries. Fourth category, that is having share of 16.8% that belongs to others, and in others, it is used for transport, health and military operations. Second largest category, that is having share of around 21.3% that belongs to ongoing services. It is used for critical aspects like software updates, bug fixing, technical support and training. And the largest category that belongs to module and sensor. It is there for a development and deployment of IT services. The reason is with the use of modules and sensors, we interface sensors with embedded system, and embedded system is being interfaced with internet, right? So, once you sense the data, you will have to forward that on internet. So, module and sensor, that is having market share of around 28.6%, right? That is highest one. That is how IoT services are categorized in terms of market share. Now, I am going to explain you last part of this video. In the last part of this video, I'll be discussing about potential of IoT. So, with the use of Internet of Things, we can upgrade our services, we can upgrade our applications, we can upgrade our work life even, right? And with those upgradation, we can have humongous amount of savings. That's why people will be definitely going to use IoT services in future. Like, it is estimated that with the use of connected machine and data, we can eliminate up to $250 billion waste across the industries. And this is what the data, that is minimum data that one can say. As per the estimation provided by General Electrical, I'll be listing few categories even by which you can understand how exactly potential of IoT is there. So here, GE's estimate on potential of just 1% of savings applied using IoT across global industry sectors that I'll be going to discuss about. So here, see, I'll be listing industry with respect to segment, and I'll explain you type of savings in tabular form, and I'll be discussing about estimated value over 15 years. So how much we can save over 15 years. So if you talk about aviation industry, then In commercial segment of aviation industry, we can save around 1% of fuel with the use of IoT, and by which we can save around $30 billion. If you talk about power industry, so in that, with gas-fired generation, we can save up to 1% of fuel, and this is what least percentage that I have listed over here, right? By which we can save around $66 billion in upcoming 15 years. If you talk about healthcare industry with system-wide segment, and if you save around 1% in reduction in the system's inefficiency, then estimated value is around $63 billion. If you talk about rail industry with freight segment, you will be observing that with 1% of reduction in systems inefficiency, we can save about $27 billion in next 15 years. If you talk about oil and gas industry, in that, if you consider the segment which is there regarding exploration and development, with the type of 1% of saving in reduction in capital expenditure, then you will be saving around $90 billion. So here I have listed few industries only, and these are the data that I have took it from General Electrical's website, where estimated saving was around only 1%, by which it have been explained over here, like more than $250 billion could be saved over here, right? So you just think about practical scenario where there can be trillions of dollars of saving in upcoming year with the use of IoT services, right? So at last, you can say sky is not the limit. It is only the beginning with IoT, as there are many possibilities that is yet to be explored in this world, and probably in future, many engineers will be using IoT services. It is not only about IT engineers, mechanical engineers, civil engineers, all the engineering categories will be using Internet of Things services. I hope you have found this video interesting. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.